Hi everyone, it's Jay Whitty. I hope you all are having a great day. If you're new to my channel, welcome. I'm glad you're here. So I'm working on a 14 by 14 stretched canvas, and my initial plan is to do a real simplistic swipe. And so I'm laying down my base coat, which is the DecoArt Dazzling Metallic Champagne Gold mixed with a little bit of the Modern Master Champagne. The DecoArt by itself with the Floetrol and Gack was just a little bit too pale, and that's why I added some Modern Master Champagne to it to darken it up just a bit. And my base coat and the colors that I chose for this piece are all mixed with the exact same pouring medium so that the consistency is also the same. It's 50% Floetrol and 50% Gack. So that's what I used for my base and my colors. My swipe color that I used today is the Amsterdam Permanent Blue Violet, and that was 1 ounce of paint to 5 ounces of Floetrol. And then I put 3 drops of the Minwax Wood Conditioner in my swipe color. I just wanted to see what kind of a result and how all of that would play together on this particular piece. So I start out laying down with the DecoArt Metallics Deep Sapphire. And I go from in a diagonal line from corner to corner. And of course my lines aren't precise. I need still a lot of practice when it comes to this. I've done swipes before where I've gone straight across the canvas, you know, from one side to another, but not from corner to corner. So this was interesting because I really need to practice. And this piece really has taken on quite the transformation. Because, like I said, I was going to do like a simplistic swipe. And I went from swipe to tilt. There's the sapphire. And several other techniques that you're going to see along the way. I struggled with this piece. So I'm laying down the sapphire, the deep sapphire from DecoArt Metallics. Next comes the DecoArt Dazzling Metallics Peacock Pearl. I follow that with DecoArt Extreme Sheen Pink Tourmaline, I think is how it's pronounced. And that is a very bossy, bossy color, as I'm going to find out with this particular piece. I follow it up with a little bit of Folk Art Metallic Antique Copper. And I put those off to the sides, thinking in my head that when I lay my swipe color down and swipe over, somehow that was going to add some contrast, interesting contrast in the overall end result. So my plan didn't really go like I thought. And at one point, I ended up really not liking my composition at all. And it was after I went through and did the swipe, then I did the tilt, then I did a smear with my palette knife, and then I laid some color down and blew it out with my straw. And you're going to see all of this. And at one point, I finally stopped the camera and decided I was just going to scrape it, go ahead and completely get rid of this video and just completely start from scratch. And I was just that frustrated with everything. And I know that we all have our days in the studio or in our art rooms where things just don't go as planned. But this little voice kept telling me, keep going at it, keep working with it. And sometimes we can overwork a painting, but try, keep trying. And that's all I kept hearing in my head was, keep going, keep going, keep going. You're not done yet. Don't scrape, keep going. So if anything, let this video be a learning, lesson. Allow for my experience to show you that if you're persistent, and before you exhaust all possibilities, give it a go. Give it a try until you've reached, you know, every possible way that you can think to save a painting before you decide to scrape. And so I did stop the video, and off camera I played with it a little bit more, and just as I was getting ready to scrape it and call it a day, I happened to glance over and saw a color sitting in one of my jars that I had left over from a previous pour. And what I did with that particular color, which was a deeper, darker copper than the one that you see here, and it's from a previous pour, so I'll have all of that information in the description box down below. And so what I did with that actually saved this painting, and it turned it into exactly what this canvas basically was screaming at me that it wanted. And so I do these voiceovers because it's difficult for me because I get in the zone, and even though my zone sometimes goes wonky on me like in this particular piece, I just get in the zone, and so it's easier for me to do the voiceovers than it is to be able to talk through the actual video as I'm actually painting. So I invite you to stick with this process and watch it in its entirety to better appreciate the end result, because this canvas certainly knew what it wanted. And I don't know, the goddess within her appears at the very end, and you'll see what I'm referring to hopefully at the end, during the end result, when I take you in for a close up. So again, if you're new to my channel, welcome. I'm so glad you're here. Please consider subscribing. Don't forget to hit the notification bell for future uploads. And like I always said, I share my successes and I share my mishaps, because it's all a learning process, and we're here to learn and teach each, learn from each other and teach each other. So if anything you learned from this particular video this time, keep on going until you've exhausted every possible means that you have available to you to transform what it is that you're not liking into something that you absolutely love. And this is what happened with me with this particular piece. So until next time, guys, stay safe, take care, and blessings to you all. Bye-bye. Thank you.